हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द बायोलॉजी क्लास। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्ट द फिफ्थ चैप्टर मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द थ्री मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज रूट, द सेकंड वन इज स्टेम, एंड द थर्ड वन इज लीफ। नाउ 21st जुलाई इज योर टर्म एग्जाम, सो दिस वीक वी हैव टू कंटिन्यू रिवीजन वीडियो। इन दिस एग्जाम वी हैव टू इंक्लूड फर्स्ट, second and eighth chapter, that is living world, biological classification and the cell unit of life. Already many times we have discussed main topics of this chapter, revise this chapter and detailed study of this chapter. So you have to already know what about the first, second and eighth chapter. The main question is also you have to give, we have to send already question bank and proper notes of this chapter. We have to already send the question and answer both in worksheet and video, worksheet and notes. So prepare well and go to the revised video. If any problem, you have to also watch the previous chapters video in our SCLT website. The in playlist all the videos are stored, so you have to watch again this video in detail and study them. If any doubt, you have to ask me, you have to call me, message me, I have solved your doubts. Now today we discuss about the first chapter, revise the first chapter, that is the living world. In this chapter we have to start what is living. We have to start this topic in the one question, what is living? Which organisms we have to include in living and non-living? So you have to know that living organisms have special characteristics. In special characteristics, it is include growth, reproduction, metabolism, self-organization, sense to environment, etc. So this is the special characteristics that is different to living organisms, to the non-living organisms. In non-living organisms, these characteristics are absent. Now we discuss about the one characteristics, and first we discuss about the main characteristic of growth. What is growth? So increase in mass and increase in number, it is known as growth. Very organisms and must be organisms are increased in mass and number. In plants, we have to show the growth is continuous during its life, but in animals, this growth are stopped to certain age. So this is the main characteristic of living organisms. All the living organisms are growth, but some non-living organisms like mountain, sand rods, etc. are also increasing mass. You have to see that in mountain, जो mountain है वो पहले से इतना बड़ा नहीं होता है, सब वो small होता है, उसके ऊपर कई सारे external accumulations है वो होते हैं और उसकी वजह से वो अपनी height increase करता है. So in mountain, certain external features are accumulation in their surface and increase in mass. But in living organisms, the increase in mass and increase in number is both the side, outer side and inner side. But in mountain, only increase in outer surface, not intelligent or not divided in internally. And living organisms are increasing mass and number in internally as well as externally. So the mountains, sand walls are not including in living organism, and that's why the growth is not defined in characteristics of the living organisms. Okay, now we discuss about the second characteristic, that is reproduction. All reproduction is the main and chief characteristic of the living organism. Mainly the organisms are reproduced and produce their offspring is known as reproduction. In developed or newborn offsprings are somehow equal to appear like its parents. In reproduction there are two types: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, fission, budding, fragmentation, etc. are the process which is including asexual reproduction. Fission in amoeba, budding in yeast, and fragmentation in moss and vanilla. And in sexual reproduction, gametes are formed. Male and female, both the gametes are formed and then it is fused. So reproduction is asexual and sexual type. In some organisms, living organisms like mole, worker honeybee, and infertile couple do not produce in their whole life. Some living organisms are not produced in your whole life. So this is the that's the living organisms that cannot produce offspring in their lifespan. So this is the living organisms, but the reproduction is not appear. So the reproduction is also not defining characteristic of living organisms. Growth and reproduction both are the special characteristic in living organisms, but somehow it is not included in defining characteristic of living organisms. Now we discuss about the third characteristics, and that is the metabolism. The metabolism is mainly appearing two words, user of two words, that is anabolism and catabolism. The total sum of anabolism and catabolism, it is known as metabolism. In anabolism and catabolism, in anabolism the energy is synthesized, and in catabolism the energy is utilized. Both are opposite reactions, and the total sum of anabolism and catabolism, it is known as metabolism. Metabolism is, it is the main defining characteristic of living organisms. In our body there are many chemical processes we have to show, that is digestion, circulation, etc. So this is all the process are included and continuous with the metabolism. Total sum of anabolism and catabolism, it is known as metabolism. Now this is the main characteristic of living organisms. In examination you have to ask various type of question in this topic, like list in one mark question you have to ask, list out the main characteristic of living organisms. So this is the list of the main characteristics. You have to ask why growth is not included in defining characteristics. So it is answer. Why reproduction is also not defining characteristics. So this is the answer. Difference between anabolism and catabolism we have to also given in worksheet video, and it is main differentiation between metabolism and catabolism. Now second topic in this chapter we have to already study, that is biodiversity. There are many various type of living organisms are living in earth. There is 1.2 to 1.8 million living organisms are present in earth, and 1.8 to 1.8 million living organisms are identified in earth. So this is a very much, so what are biodiversity present in earth? So we have to various name given in our area. We have to show dog, animal, etc. organisms and neem, mango tree, etc. plant organism. So in particular area we have to give a particular name, but in general, in scientific or in international, in universe, we have to give a very one common name to all organisms, and that is given the name, process of the given of universe name, it is known as nomenclature. And this nomenclature are the very much famous system in biology. So the nomenclature, the name given of the name in on universe level, it is known as nomenclature. So in nomenclature we have to decide some rules for biodiversity. So it is also asking for examination, write down the rules of nomenclature. So the rules of nomenclature is, first the name is divided, or the name is the made up of two main components. The first word is generic name, and second one is specific epithet. We have to give the example, that is Mangifera. Indica, it is the common name of mango tree, Mangifera indica. So the first is the generic name and the second one is specific epithet. Mangifera indica, the common name is mango. In Mangifera indica, it is the first rule is, that is the Latinized word, originate from the Latin word. The second one is first letter is denote genus, and second word is denote the species name. The third rule is, the first letter is written in capital letters. See, the Mangifera, the M is capital, and the second letter is writing small alphabetic letter, that is indica. The fourth rule of this, that is the Mangifera indica, have written in handwriting written separated line row is compulsory, but you have to write in printed. It is write up in italic font. This is the fourth rule. And last, we have to write the scientist name. So the scientist name is written in last of species and abbreviated form, like Mangifera indica, LINN. LINN, it is a because this scientific name is given by the Carolus Linnaeus. So, in Linnaeus name we have written after the species name in abbreviated form. This is given two components. So, it is known as two kingdom classification. And this system is given by Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, so this is the main rules of the biological nomenclature. You have to ask in examination 3 marks question. Write down the rules of biodiversity nomenclature. So you have to write the. Now we discuss about the main topic of this chapter, that is the taxonomic categories. In every living organisms, we have to classify or we have to include in particular phylum, particular class, particular order. So this sequence in including all the characteristics in various phylum class is known as the taxonomic categories. We have to discuss that 7 type of taxonomic categories are included in biology or the living world, and we have to give a trick for shortcut, that is keep pot clean and family get sick. This is your shortcut trick. So first category is kingdom, second category is phylum. In plants it is also known as the division, then class, then family, then genus, and last one is species. So this is the 7 categories of the taxonomic, and we have to know that ascending orders, this is to kingdom. The similarities are different and differentiate are more. But in descending order, kingdom to the species, the more similarities are equal and differentiated are the dissimilar. So this is the 7 type of categories. Now we discuss about the example of this. So we have to 3 type of species: Panthera leo, Panthera pardus, and Panthera tigris. So this is the 3 main species: Leo, Panthera pardus, and tigris. But the genus is same, Panthera. In this, the 3 are the common characteristic of some, because this is the including the family of cat family. This is the species, this is the genus. These all are included in 2 main family, that is Felidae and Canidae. So these both are 3 are included in Canidae family, but differentiate into the Felidae family. The Canidae family is all included in cat, and Felidae is included in dog. So these 3 are totally differentiated into the family of dog. Now Canidae family, both are included in common class, that is the Carnivora. Both are included in the Carnivora because they are carnivorous animal. Now it is totally differentiated into the Herbivora class. So this is Herbivora and Carnivora, and both the family are included in Carnivora. And now Carnivora and Herbivora are included in phylum vertebrata. This is also totally differentiated into the non-vertebrata phylum. Vertebrata and non-vertebrata. And both vertebrata and non-vertebrata are including the kingdom Animalia. This is the differentiated into the plantae. So, you have to discuss about the similarity. We have to start the species to the kingdom. You have to see that the more similarities are included in the ascending order. But descending order, you have to get more dissimilarities, and similarities are separated. So this is the species to the kingdom classification of taxonomic categories. In examination, you have to ask, write down the short note on species with suitable example. Write down the short note on genus with suitable examples. So you have to write examples, definition, both are included in 3 marks short note. Now last topic of this chapter is taxonomic aids. The taxonomic aids, it is very much important for the living organisms, because this is the very much helpful in various branches of biology, like forestry, fisheries, etc. So in taxonomic aids, we have to first include, that is, herbarium. In herbarium, it is the preserve of various plant living organisms in mainly 3 processes. First one is collection, second one is braced, and third one is preserved. We have to collect some plant organisms or plant root, leaf, seeds, etc. And we have to collect, then we have to press in, we have to clean this all the parts in water, and totally dry we have to use the blotting paper. In blotting paper we have to totally press, so the extra water is removed. And last one, we have to, these parts are for reference purpose and long time of collect, so we have to preserve in some materials. So this is the 3 main processes of herbarium. In herbarium sheet, you have to also show that collection or collection place, collection date, area, name, local name, national name, scientific name, etc. are given in herbarium sheet. So it is very much useful in research purpose. Now second taxonomic aid is the botanical garden. In botanical garden, the plants, living plants are collected. In natural condition, the biggest botanical garden and the famous botanical garden is Kew in England. So the botanical gardens are very much useful in research purpose, study purpose. In some colleges, our own, it's your own botanical garden. Now third one is museum. Students, already we have to discuss about museum. We also know about museum, and we also visit to the museum. In museum, some dead organisms are collected in bottle, jars, etc. The also biggest animal is collected by the stuffing process. And museum is very much famous and very much interesting and very much useful for the study and research. research purpose. In some colleges and universities, it's also your own museums. And last we discussed about the zoological park. In zoological park, animals, living animals are protected in its natural habitat. So the zoological park is very much famous, and zoo is very much famous for the child, very much famous and interesting. We have to visit this park and show that very much animals are living in its natural habitat. So this is the taxonomy. It's useful for study, research, etc. purpose. Last one, we use the keys. The monographs, the manuals, it is very much useful for the biodiversity or the taxonomical things. Because in manuals and monographs, in localized area, some plants we have to know and some plants we don't know. So in another person's study our area, we have to give the manuals or monographs. And in manuals and monographs, totally the area are localized, and totally areas living organisms are included in, and totally things are included. So it is very much easy for the research students or research purpose. So keys, herbarium, zoological park, botanical park, and a museum, it is a very much useful taxonomic aids. Now for only one question you have to do, very much important in your examination. In your textbook, man, housefly, mango, except four main living organisms are given and classified into its category. So you have to totally write these four main living organisms into its taxonomic category, and it is very much important question for your examination. So prepare that. In your question bank, we have to give the 1, 2, 3 marks, 4, 5 marks question. You have to study well, you have to prepare well, and even if you have to doubt, call me or message me. All the very best, and thank you.